Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum, dear students. Welcome to the online lecture on linear control systems theory. So previously we discussed Routh Hurwitz stability criteria, and in continuation to that lecture, I would like to discuss the controller design example using Routh Hurwitz stability criteria. In this example, we shall be looking at a transfer function, which is 1 over s into s cube plus s square plus s plus 1. This is a fourth order transfer function, and we wish to find out or design the controller that can render the closed loop system with this transfer function to be asymptotically stable. So we are given this transfer function, and we are looking to design the controller here such that this overall system is asymptotically stable. So for stability, we do not have the desired value of output. Desired value of output for stability is zero. So stability means that we want to derive the output to zero value. Okay, so we start with the controller design example. You can see the first question that we have to answer here is that what kind of controller should we try. So because we have discussed a couple of lectures ago, there are many types of controller: P controller, PD controller, PI controller, PID controller, phase lead, phase lag compensators are there as well. So what type of controller? Well, a simple answer to that is that our controller should be as simple as possible. So in this case, since there is no S term missing in this transfer function, all the powers of S are there. Therefore, we do not need any derivative part in principle to stabilize this system. So the simplest possible controller here is P controller. Suppose if there was an S term missing here, then the simplest possible controller would be PD controller. Because we need all the terms to be non-zero in order to apply Routh Hurwitz. Okay, what is the transfer function of a P controller? It's simple, constant gain KP, and then the resulting closed loop transfer function with the P controller becomes C of S into G of S divided by 1 plus C of S G of S. That will be equal to, if you take the LCM and plug in all the values of G of S and C of S, then after some simplification you will get KP over S square plus S cube plus S square plus S plus KP. So this is the closed loop transfer function with P controller. So with this transfer function, we have this characteristic polynomial. So we shall be applying Routh Hurwitz on this characteristic polynomial of the closed loop system to see if it is asymptotically stable or not. So next slide, we copy the characteristic polynomial here. So this is the characteristic polynomial. Necessary condition of the Routh Hurwitz required that all the signs of the coefficients of characteristic polynomial should be same. Here the coefficients of all the powers of S are positive. Therefore, to satisfy the necessary condition, the controller gain has to be positive. We now look at the sufficient condition. So for sufficient condition, we need to build the Routh Hurwitz table, and you already know how to make this table. So we line up all the powers of S onto the table, and then we fill in the first row of S to the power 4 with the coefficient of S raised to the power 4, and then next comes the coefficient of S square, and next come the constant coefficient. Similarly, we can fill in the coefficients of S cube. This one is the coefficient of S cube, and then the next one is the coefficient of S, and then there is no coefficient, so we put zero here. And now we keep in filling the table, and we found a zero in the first element of a row. We already know how to deal with that. We just replace this zero with a infinitesimally small number epsilon. So we just do that, like replace this 0 with a small number epsilon, and then calculate this value of A. Here A would be epsilon minus Kp, so epsilon into 1 minus 1 into Kp divided by epsilon. This will be the value of A, and next this Kp come down here as it is. So you can see that we already have this first column completed of the Routh Hurwitz table, and now we look at the signs of these determinants. One is positive, this is positive. We can assume any sign for epsilon, so we assume epsilon to be positive for our convenience. And the sign of A we don't know, but sign of Kp already we know that in order to satisfy necessary condition, Kp has to be positive. So finally we are left with this A. If we look at this, A is equal to epsilon minus Kp over epsilon. Since we have assumed epsilon to be positive, and we know that Kp has to be positive in order to satisfy necessary condition, so A cannot be positive. A will be negative if we choose Kp to be positive. On the other hand, if we assume the sign of the epsilon to be negative, then regardless of the value of Kp, the condition is not going to be satisfied, because these two determinants are positive. If we assume epsilon to be negative, straight away we lose asymptotic stability. So the conclusion is that there is no possible value of Kp that can achieve closed loop asymptotic stability in this case. So what do we do? Well, since P controller did not work, you know, for achieving closed loop asymptotic stability, we try another controller. So which controller do we try next? We try the PD controller. We do not try PI controller because the integral part is related to steady state performance. We have not discussed the steady state performance yet. We have already only discussed the stability. So the controller types that are related to stability are proportional controller and derivative controller. So we have already tried proportional controller. It did not work. So next we try proportional derivative controller. So this is the statement that I just told you, that P controller did not work, and the reason is the closed loop stability. Excuse me. So next choice of simplest possible controller is PD controller. Okay, so PD controller has the transfer function Kp plus Kds. So this I have written here as well. And then the resulting closed loop transfer function of this whole system with PD controller shall be 1 CS into GS over 1 plus CS into GS. That will be Kp plus Kds divided by S raised to the power 4 plus S cube plus S square plus S times 1 plus Kd plus Kp. So this is the characteristic polynomial with our new controller, and in order for this characteristic polynomial to satisfy the necessary condition, we need to have Kp greater than 0 and Kd greater than minus 1. So Kd can be negative, but it cannot be minus 1 or less than minus 1, otherwise the coefficient of this S term will become negative. Alright, so we have looked at the necessary condition, we have looked at the characteristic polynomial, now we look at the sufficient condition. So for sufficient condition, we do as we always do, that we make the Routh Hurwitz table, and in this table we fill in the values from this characteristic polynomial, coefficient of S raised to the power 4, then coefficient of S square, then constant coefficient which is Kp, then the coefficient of S cube, then coefficient of S, then there is no more coefficient to fill in, so we have a 0 here, and similarly we keep going. We have A, which is 1 times 1 minus 1 times 1 plus Kd divided by 1. Then B similarly will be A times 1 plus Kd minus 1 Kp divided by A. And similarly we have this complete table. Alright, so we have looked at the table, now we look at the expression of A. Since A is equal to 1 into 1 minus 1 into 1 plus Kd, which I have written here, divided by 1. If you see, this 1 will cancel out with this 1, and you will have minus kd over 1, which is minus kd. So a is equal to minus kd. Similarly, b is equal to a times 1 plus kd, which it means that this is minus kd square, and minus kp, all of them are negative, so we take out the negative sign, and divided by a, which is again minus kd, so the negative sign of the numerator cancels out with the negative sign of the denominator, and b turns out to be kd plus kd square plus kp whole divided by kd. And now finally we have to see if all of these determinants are positive or not. So this is positive, this is positive. A can only be positive if kd is negative, and then b can be positive if we select some negative kd, and we can choose the corresponding kp which will make this whole term to be positive. So there are many choices for kp and kd that can make both a and b positive simultaneously. Once we do that, we shall be having but whatever you do, you cannot choose kp to be negative, and kd has to be greater than minus 1, but this shows that kd has to be less than 0 as well. So kd has to be between minus 1 and 0. You can pick up any value of kd between minus 1 and 0, and then that will dictate the value of kp or range of kp that will render this b to be positive. For example, if I choose kd equal minus 0.5, then a will become plus 0.5, and there will be a range of kp. In this case, if I pick kd to be minus 0.5, the range of kp for which b can be greater than 0, you can calculate by simple mathematics, and that will turn out to be between 0 and 0.25, and I can pick any value of kp between 0 and 0.25. I choose 0.1, and if I choose kp to be 0.1 and kd to be minus 0.5, then b turns out to be plus 0.55, which is positive. So closed loop system is asymptotically stable by Routh Hurwitz criteria, because with these choices of kp and kd, your all of these determinants are positive, and all of these coefficients are also positive. Both of the conditions of Routh Hurwitz criteria are met, so we have closed loop asymptotic stability, and our final controller shall be 0.1 minus 0.5s. so here we will have 0.1 minus 0.5 into s. That will be the transfer function of our controller that will achieve closed loop stability with this type of plant. So this was the example of controller design with Routh Hurwitz stability criteria. I hope you were able to understand what I have delivered here. I just summarize the learning points from today's lecture. First is that you start with the simplest possible controller. In our example, simplest possible controller was the P controller, because there was no S term missing. And then if the stability is not achieved, add a derivative part into the controller and try again, and keep on changing the controller until the stability is achieved. So in our example, once we added the derivative part with the proportional controller, the stability was achieved. But imagine if the stability were not achieved with PD controller, then we would have to try PDD controller with two derivative parts, where one derivative part is with simple S, and the other derivative part would have been with S square. So this is how you design the controller using Routh Hurwitz stability criteria. I will just briefly summarize this whole lecture in a minute and a half. So I go back to the beginning of this lecture, So we discussed that we have a transfer function, which is fourth order transfer function, and we need to design the controller in order to achieve the closed loop stability. We looked at which controller we should try. We should try the simplest possible controller, which is the P controller in this case, and the transfer function is KP, CS is equal to KP, and the resulting closed loop transfer function, this has the characteristic polynomial, which we inspect and see that this characteristic polynomial will satisfy the necessary condition. If KP is greater than 0, then we build the Routh table. In the Routh table, we encountered the special case, but after some calculations, we found out that there is no feasible value of KP that can make this system, closed loop system, asymptotically stable. So we have to change the controller. We add a derivative part, and then we looked at the resulting updated transfer function and its characteristic polynomial, and we see that for necessary condition of Routh Hurwitz, the KP should be positive and KD should be greater than -1. And we then built the Routh table. In that table, we calculated all the Routh determinants in the first column, and we found that we actually do have many choices for KP and KD, which will make all the determinants positive. Out of those many choices, we picked KD equal -0.5 and KP equal 0.1, which resulted in the values of A and B both positive, which are written here. You can also do these calculations by hand and verify them. And then in summary, you start with simplest controller, and if the stability is not achieved, you add the derivative part and try again, and until the stability is achieved, you keep on adding the derivative parts. So thank you very much for listening. That's all.